Good morning and welcome everyone. There is one thing common between we and you all attendees is that we all are working from home and even for home. So thank you for taking out your time out of your busy schedule to attend this webinar. And I hope like whoever are attending here are safe and fine. Even your family, friend and your circle is healthy. So stay safe. So let's back to this webinar. So once again, welcome you all. So today's topic is join live webinar, which is unleash the potential of interoperability by using Cadmatic exchanges. My name is Dharmendra Awasthi. Working as a technical lead for Cadmatic with Plant Marine and Information Management Solution. So this is the agenda, webinar agenda about this topic. So first I'll go through what is interoperability in general, then its need. Third, I'll talk about what are the Cadmatic offerings for this solution. List of Cadmatic exchanges, then exchanges for structural and mechanical models, then external data management, Cadmatic web API, latest development news about Cadmatic solution, Cadmatic exchanger function, and its file format. A chart is there. I will explain the chart. Then how this entire concept is benefiting owner and operator with the concept of digital twin. Everything you can combine and link, that gives you the benefit. Like more detail I'll speak later stage. Then quickly I'll go through our information management key benefits and features. Finally, I'll summarize this whole session with the benefits. So once again, thank you for your attention. So first, very basic, a general thing. What is interoperability? It is a characteristic where two body or system whose interface are completely understood to work with other product or system at current stage or in future, which helps without any restriction, quick access and good implementation, I would say. The purpose of this is like concept, make it possible that they can talk and understand each other information. It involves the task of building a coherent service for the user when an individual are technically at different location or system or department. If there is a lack of this concept, it can be a consequence that there is a lack of attention given to the standardization during the design. Indeed, this concept, interoperability, is not taken any granted in a non-standard based portion of the computing world. It is very important. So widely used in various types of industry, CAD industry, healthcare, infrastructure, aerospace. Why need for this? Now I'll focus on the CAD side. Slowly I'll move to the CAD concept. So for CAD viewing purpose, it's a very important part where you can see the model which is originating from one software and you're viewing them in another software. Which in this you are saving your cost. Translation, if you wanted to convert your file from one file format to another file format so that it can be open in other system and software. CAD model repair. So if the model is originally built, model is poor or it is not properly converted, then you need to repair them. Then CAD comparison and validation. Both are very much crucial because you need to know what changes your customer have introduced in the revision, or you need to validate them, whatever given or you have got in the original file format. Then the automation. Basically, in this case, like some automation of multiple conversion repair can be done at a time. There are few more reasons why this is required to avoid dependency on one platform. Next, also it's difficult to maintain and provide same expensive software solution for everyone in the project design community. And if the competitive products are not interoperable, maybe due to the reason of patent, trade secret or coordination failure, but this may result into monopoly and even a market failure. So for this reason, it may be prudent for a user, community or government to take a step to encourage this concept in various situations. And now if I talk about CAN industry, many big giant companies have adopted this multi-CAN strategy. So with this, I will complete this neat part. Now let's have a look what CANmatic is offering and exchanges available. So first of all, CANmatic software has various set of interoperability solutions, which are known as exchanges, which allow smooth cooperation, integration, and interfacing with other technology supplier and software system. These exchanges enable easy transfer between the software, and it gives an option to whether you want to include the data or you just use as a reference model. Then once your model is there, you can have any kind of extraction of your document, whether it's a DWG, PDF, or DXF. Now, in CANmatic, if both interoperability and exchanger conceptually they are same. So I may be using exchanger and this word interoperability, but both one and the same. So I will quickly show you the list of exchanges available with CANmatic. So these are the list of exchanger available: exchanger for PDMS, SP3D, PDS, AutoCAD, with Tekla. Then you can import various file formats in JT, ISP file format. Then a point cloud manager. Then we also have an interface to export a stress analysis format for stress analysis software. Also, we have interface for E3D.CG's electrical diagrams, external data management, and web API. So this is quite a good list, and we'll go through all of this in next 20-25 minutes. So first I will talk about exchanger for PDMS. So this is the interface where you can see the file, tool, and help command, where there are some background settings which you can do. Input file for this converter is PDMS review file, which is in a .rvm file format, and the PDMS attribute file, which is .att. These two files you can export from a PDS software. Later you can attach here in our interface. If you wanted to, after attaching, if you wanted to divide them as per the attribute available or information available behind the object, based on site information attribute, you can do it. Also, if you wanted to exclude some part of it, still you can exclude with the user feature. And so suppose some file size, some part of the RVM is very heavy, it must be some imported from other software, so you can make it transparent and light in size. Then you attach the attribute file, you set the output path and the file name. Then there will be attribute mapping file, color setting file. Using this attribute mapping file, you can map the attribute, which is automatically happening by default, but still further you can configure it. Say if you want color as per PDMS, as per system, as per site, as per zone, all those things you can configure under this. Then we have a color mapping file. Once you complete this, you just click a hit button, so you get this output. So now from right now throughout the exchanger, this output flow is same. The moment the conversion gets completed successfully, you get an output as a review file, CANmatic review file, which will open in e-browser application. You will have a .cdd file, which you can use just as a reference model in your project. And you also have an option to intelligently add or map with the existing attributes and the color system color, and even the structure of that source software. So 3D exchanger for PDS is a conversion program that converts PDMS design review model to CANmatic review file format and even a 3D model. Now there are some sample which is converted. There is an offshore plant, there is some power plant, and even an oil and gas plant on the right. So let's have a short video, 2-minute video, how this exchanger works. So these are the prerequisites which I have explained you in the previous slide. Interface where you can attach the RVM file. You have a choice. You can select all of them or you can select one by one. You can divide them by various methods. then you can then you have to attach its attribute file, set the export path and the file name, then attach a attribute mapping file, color setting file and attribute color mapping file. Once you do this, you can do the further design or the configuration with the attribute. So automatically everything gets mapped. Even you can create the new hierarchy, or the hierarchy as same as PDMS. Color also, you can have the PDMS same color as per site, as per zone, as per system. Color rule you can set. Then there is a color mapping of RGB values with the shine. And there are still more detailed configuration available. If you wanted to know more about this, we can have this detailed session with you and your company. Once the export is done, I just opened our review file format in an e-browser file where I have opened the attribute. So you can see the attribute style is same as the PDMS attribute style and even hierarchy on the left-hand side. So this way, if you are doing any review job, you can convert and use our review solution to do the review projects. Then you can, after you convert, you can measure, you can add markups, coordinate. Also, you can clip the project for detailed view or close-up view for a large-scale project. Then you can also compare the revisions in our solution. You can also check the clash. So you can compare projects. And if you want to have a 3D, just you activate this button, click OK and run the conversion. This way it exports a .3DD file, which is a Cadmatic native file format. Import it. So this is a Cadmatic user interface, 3D user interface, where you are right now, you are under 3D import manager. Just now I have attached this 3DD file. With the create button, I'll scan the attribute and colors. Later, I will click the import button. The import button, scan model. With this, with some seconds or a minute, based on the file size, the import is complete. Then using this imported model, you can further do the expansion project. You can take a reference of it and so on for HP3D. So again, this is the interface where you can see this is the input file .sat or .vue. It's a geometry file and attribute file in XML file format. So you can attach file, the geometry file over here, attribute file at this option. You can set the path for export, set the name for export, set the scale. Suppose if the incoming or the model is in meters or millimeter, based on that you can set the scale factor. There is a attribute mapping path and file, attribute filter file. If you don't want, you can filter them. Then hit the conversion button. The moment you click the conversion button and conversion is successful, you get as an output, you get the Cadmatic, which is a Cadmatic review file, Cadmatic 3D file. And if you do some little work, you can also have a output of 3D file with, along with the attribute and color, system color, as well as the structure. So this is how, and the purpose of this exchanger. So this is one sample converted project where you can see the attribute are in the same fashion of SP3D, same way you can map the hierarchy or the structure. So next, I will run a quick short video which will explain you about this exchanger working. So this is exchanger for SP3D. The moment I click, this is the interface which I have already explained you. Now you can quickly attach the geometry file. Attribute file, which is an XML file format. You can set the output path wherever you want. It can be a common drive or centralized location. You set the path for a 3D and review file export. Configure the attribute filter file, mapping file, and hit the start conversion button. The moment the conversion gets complete, you get a pop-up message of successful conversion. and you can see the file getting appearing or created in this interface. Now I will quickly open a review file to show how this review model it appears at this. I can see the attributes. If I see the object property, I can see the attribute style same as SP3D. And if you see on the left hand side, now you will see the even the tree, object tree or hierarchy is also same as SP3D. Now same way after this, you can perform all the review tool operation on it. Now next is we'll convert, you will use this exported 3D model of SP3D in our 3D design tool, where you can further design or you make use of all the modules we import. Now let's move on to the next one, interface for PDS. So this is the interface. The working is more or less same like the PDMS. Just in this case, you need to use, these are the input files, .dgn or .prp and .drv as an attribute file. This both the file, it's a geometry and attribute file, you can keep in one folder while loading inside this because they get auto sync. Then you attach them, set the output path, attribute mapping. You can do the color setting, color mapping. Then you have option here to select out of all the DGN which one you wanted to convert right now or use for the conversion. You select it, you click the convert button, then you get a cadmatic review file as an output and even the 3D file with and without attribute based on the selection and the choice you have made. So this way you can convert a PDS model into cadmatic formats. Some sample PDS converted models. Now let's quickly look at 3D exchanger for AutoCAD. So with this exchange, any 2D document you can directly import export from our solution, and we have an inbuilt converter for it, which we call it as 2D exchanger. Then using this converter exchanger, you are able to import your existing PNID. One good example I'm giving in a DXF and DWG format. Later you can convert them into intelligent PNID using our inbuilt features for that. You can also import them with and without attributes and even the color, the studio drawings. Further, if you wanted to import export 3D, you need to use like exchanger for AutoCAD, which are AutoCAD plugins. So when you install this exchanger, it will ask you which AutoCAD version you are using. You select that when it is prompted. So you select, then automatically this way you are actually creating a bridge between other CAD system and cadmatic. Basically what I'm trying to say, AutoCAD is managed to open and export any kind of files, most of the files. So once you have a bridge between AutoCAD and cadmatic, you can import export various types of files. So this, there are interface for this. So this interface, it's a cadmatic to AutoCAD, where you can see there are some options to improve the quality and the type of conversion, and these are option help us to have a good quality export. So this is from cadmatic to AutoCAD. Next one is allowing you to export, import, or I can say from AutoCAD to cadmatic. So these two interface works very well, widely used across the cadmatic customers. Cadmatic point cloud manager, again it's a converter basically, where the globally available, like there are globally available scanner device, 3D scanner device, Faro, Leica and many more. These all software have the functionality to read them and export in a neutral file format, which are SC, TTS, XYZ, and even E57, and last but .ptx. So this is the interface from our solution where you can import all these files. Once this converter gets complete the import process, it actually converts these neutral file formats of point cloud data to the cadmatic point cloud data or the file format. So these are the file formats. So this is ASCII point clouds, which are neutral files. You need them along with the scan location file, which is in text file format. Then you need E57 point cloud file, .ptx. So once you use any of these files, automatically our software converts them into one of these file format based on the choice you had selected. We have a cadmatic panoramic point cloud for a very good quality panoramic view for large scale point cloud. Also, we have the old one and the good quality one, CPX, CPD, and CPE. So output of this process, the import process actually convert the point cloud data to a cadmatic native file format. So what is the use of this? These output file can be used for walkthrough in our review tool, training and inspection purpose. You can use this in our design solution for redesign or modernization of the SCAN project, that is revamp, broad retrofit, brownfield projects, and for the project lifecycle management in Cadmatic software solution. These are some sample of point cloud in Cadmatic solutions. On the left, you can see this is a review tool and some 3D modeling is in progress. Now we will quickly go through some exchanges for structural. Like we have a good integration with Tekla structures. You can import to and fro and vice versa, I would say, from Tekla with the help of IFC file format. Also, you can import a steel profile from STAT Pro or even Tekla in the format of .sdn or sdnf. Basically, once you do this, these converted profiles becomes a cadmatic native beads. Also, we have an exchanger for Aquino Polytrans. So this Aquino Polytrans, it's a converting organization which produce translators or converters. They have a huge variety of it. Especially, they have increased the capability with the mechanical CAD software. 100 plus mechanical CAD software they support. Now to work with this exchanger, file format is .cdp. Next, I'll show you what are the various stress analysis interface available with us and even for electrical software. So Bentley AutoPipe. So for this, you can use the .cif file. For K-Pipe also, you can use the same file format. For Caesar 2, like again, the .cif file or PCF if it is helpful. Then for PipeStress, you can directly export a .tts file format. Then if you wanted to link our diagram module or our solution with the E3 series electrical diagrams, you can use this interface and this will help us to even to do the further electrical design and will be used in our AAC module as well as cable router module. Until now, I have talked about import export of 3D and etc. But now I will be talking to the next level. Now import with attribute and color is done. Now let's suppose if other than design solution, if there are information in ERP, PLM or any other system, if you want to have those information available, because it will be very helpful if these attributes or information available with the 3D model as well as the PNID module. So let's see like how it works. So Cadmatic allow externally defined object data to be imported in XML format. So these, once you use this information gets stored in our environment. Like for example, an ERP or PDM system have some information which will be useful in 3D model as well as PNID diagram object. So you can directly link them. So once you link it, so and it is in our environment. So this information will be distributed across all the users in the same network or in the same location. Within the design designers, if you have a distributed work at different location, so our environment or cost replication process will take care of it, and the same information will be available across the design location and they will work concurrently. So how it works, when you have this object imported, it will be freely available. We call it as EDM object. So moment the EDM, you are assigning or linking an EDM object to a Cadmatic object with some process in the sense with the help of an attribute tag or some special attributes. So this information will be visible and available. You also have a control, like suppose 20 attributes are coming in an XML file. You can filter them and assign only the required thing on the objects. So to work on this concept in Cadmatic, there are two ways. One is the Cadmatic, we have our own format of XML file, plus DexP XML format also can be used. Now, until now, I'm using the XML part. We also have a functionality where instead of doing a two-step process from an external solution to XML and Cadmatic, we can directly use our web API solution. So what is web API? Basically, in this, we build an interface which allows the information to pass to and fro automatically between the two different systems. So it enables the transfer of project data, in short, between Cadmatic application and all the various software available under project lifecycle. It eliminates the gap in information flow between the system and make the project data more coherent. So this is a pictorial representation. So on the left, there is the Cadmatic environment and the projects. On the right, there is various systems, third-party system, PDM, PLM, ERP. So if we develop an interface, the both can share the information, exchange the information. Then this helps us to bring all the project data close, and it is available to all the designers. So this helps them to work with high quality and without wasting any time for right information or referring multiple system and devices. In other way, it also saves your time because you are saving also the money in this case. Web API, if I talk about it, supports reading, creating, updating document as well, even apart attribute, object with a position, ID and attributes, and you can also fetch the document publication files. So in short, this web API allows you to create an interface and automatically update the information between the different systems without any manual intervention. So to know more about this, there will be upcoming day, there will be webinars in detail about this EDM and web API. The near future, if you wanted to know, let us know, contact us, or you add in the chat box. We'll share more information about this too. Next, there are some development news. So first is, now it is possible to import a PDMS library directly into Cadmatic library. So this will be beneficial for many existing and the prospect customers. Soon there will be an exchanger for Navisworks. So you will, the way I have converted and worked with PDS and PDMS, same with the Navisworks file, I will be able to do it. I can use this file, convert into a review file format, and even a CD file format with and without attribute. Two news of near future with Cadmatic exchanges. Then this chart, I will not go in too much detail. When you have this video link, you can go through it, but I have segregated the exchanges. So we have like exchanger for 3D models. So these are the types. Then we have interface for various test analysis software from our solution. Then for manufacturing, for structural and equipment, for 3D laser scanning, and for external system data. So this is the complete overview of all the exchanges and the file formats. This information are more or less available even on our website, which I will be sharing you on a follow-up email. Now, until now, we have seen conversion of object, importing and mapping attributes, color, system, and hierarchy. Okay, but now the biggest advantage when you do this and you're using a Cadmatic solution, you can take full advantage of this, and the owner and operator will have a lot highest benefit when an EPC company or consultant will implement this for them. So just consider this left image. This is the owner and operator office. So these are the various subcontractors available working on the different software design application and even different data systems. So or even a database. You can use a converter, a web API or EDM. You can combine them at the master data model, master model. Once this model is ready, you can just publish them to our eShare solution. So what is eShare? eShare is our information solution, management solution, where you, not only the design data or the exported data will be appearing. Along with this, you can link various third-party systems, which is useful for operation, management, maintenance management, inspection, health, safety, or construction management, and so on. So this is the focus area. So the next slide, this is the tool-wise I'm talking. This next slide will show you the pictorial or the how it is actually works. So this image you can see at the center, your complete combined project discipline, combined database is available at the center, which is linked to various database software, various document management software, even detailed design software documents, and so on. So you can have a look on this. Then next is, I will just quickly take you to the key benefits of eShare solution. So basically, eShare is like a, you will be seeing all the information are populating on the object or the model. So once you click a model, you will see all the information, whether it's information from external system or from the design application or with the help of an Excel you are updating, and even externally created document or internally created document, all you will see on one right click. And what is the advantage of this? This concept basically gives you a feel true digital twin is appearing in front of you with the help of an eShare. Whatever application you have used until now, but you can combine them with the help of an eShare, and an owner and operator can take a full advantage of it. So what it does, it allow you to switch between 2D models and the project document, even the external systems. So with 3D model review, allow you to 3D model review and track the design status. You have all the types of attributes with which you can play and you can configure for various purposes. Like for example, with the help of an attribute, you can check the material, you can visualize, or you can have in as a tree hierarchy, material construction state, you can, status, design progress, material availability, and many more. So basically, eShare allows you to have a real-time monitoring of the project. It is not a data center. It is not storing the data. It displays the data from external system. One big thing, major thing you keep in mind. So this way you can complete it and you can hand over this to the your owner and operator, the complete project. Like I already mentioned, we have integration to various systems, adapters, or the exchangers to exchange the data with this system, up-to-date information. So with this, I will conclude the eShare benefits. Now the next slide, I will quickly summarize our today's webinar. So Cadmatic have our own database where a different module, PNID module, CD module, electrical module, a plant layout, or even a piping design are working concurrently in sync. And also you can export, import data from external system like Excel, Access, XUL, even PDS, SP3D, AutoCAD, Tekla, Point Cloud, various mechanical software, or even export, import, stress analysis. All this, what I mentioned is interoperability. Then you can work concurrently from different locations. You can have an integration with the help of EDM as an XML, or you can directly use a web API to connect the external system data. Once your design is complete, you can extract for any kind of deliverables for project construction and planning, isometry, 2D, 3D, MTOs. Then all this entire thing, you can publish in an eShare environment automatically, or even you can attach them periodically. So all this information will be linked to the 2D, 2D model, 3D model will be linked to its various information. Then you can also link with the project management, use it for project management, construction site management, PLM, DMA, or document management. And even for operational maintenance and even healthcare and safety. So all this combined thing, what Cadmatic offer to any client, if you are using our compute solution, along with the 3D design solution, exchangers, and the information management solution. Whatever I have shown in the previous slide, I'll just quickly summarize, like this is what the key benefit of this webinar. With the help of Exchanger, you can convert any 3D model. Import export is very friendly. You can reuse the 2D and 3D legacy data in the project from basic to detailed design. As I already mentioned, we are very open, and numerous interoperability function enable us to easily use or transfer data between the system. It also allows you to use it just as a reference model or with the metadata or stored information. Finally, its main help is, or advantage is, you can combine or convert the various discipline or the software information and a model in a single project and a platform with the optimized tool for the plant layout, and you can further take its advantage for project lifecycle management. So this is, with this, my main part of this presentation gets over.